What an interesting and relevant story. Aren't you glad we heard it all, Champ? Someday, Quill, I'm gonna blast you out an airlock.
I have not yet gotten to the most important part.
Kill me.
There is a legend of the Celestial One, the chosen one who shall arrive from the stars to use the Eternity Forge.
This Celestial One, what are they like?
Advanced intellect, emotionally mature, a wise being capable of navigating the dark waters of immense power. Someone who can see beyond his own selfish desires to choose for the greater good.
Yeah, I think you got the wrong guy here. I'm just a kid from Earth.
It does not matter where you were born. It only matters what you do. You are the Celestial One, Peter.
Oh, you're so full of crap, lady. If Pete is this Celestial Watson, then why didn't the stupid forge work? Sure, it brought him back. But when we tried to use it again on someone else, it didn't do a damn thing.
Your loss. I can feel it has been with you for some time. The forge is limited right now. It can only restore life to a body that is mostly whole and undeteriorated.
I am Groot.
Ah, that explains Hala's delightful corpse collection.
She'll bring them all back if she gets the forge.
Fantastic! So it's incredibly useful to our worst enemy, but useless to us.
It can be made more useful.
How?
The Celestial One must deliver the forge to the sacred shrine. There you can unlock its true power, or destroy it forever.
And that true power is what?
Returning anyone, from any time period, back to the realm of the living. Lost ones, loved ones, I suppose hated ones too. If you were so inclined, though I do not know why. That seems ill-advised.
Why would I destroy the forge? This thing sounds awesome. Hala!
Its awesomeness comes with a price.
Yeah.
Life energy cannot be made. It must be transferred.
So someone still has to die for the thing to work.
Let's finish our drinks and go use this thing.
Yes!
Really? Who are you planning to kill?
Well, you're kind of annoying me right now.
Hala wants to use the forge to raise her army. We have to destroy
it. Until my family is returned to me.
Right? Groot says he's on my side.
No.
It's 3-1, Gamora. We win.
That is not true. Groot feels the opposite.
I mean, maybe something got lost in translation. Hey, you try and understand that I am Groot all the time. Those three words can mean anything.
You mistranslated Groot. On purpose. How long have you been doing this?
I just slipped up. This was a one-time thing.
I am Groot.
Okay, a two-time thing.
So, it is a tie then.
Two for using.
I am Groot.
I'm gonna take a guess. He said two for destroying it.
Don't you get what this means? We can bring back anyone that we lost.
Wow. Okay, this is, it's a lot to process here. Kind of heavy on the responsibility, you know? Let me think on it.
Well, one way or another, this all ends at the shrine. Can you take us there, Mantis?
I have never been, but with your help, I believe I can sense its location. May we have some space to concentrate?
Gladly. If anyone needs me, I'll be emotionally unavailable.
And that's you.
You have extraordinarily soft hands. Like, wow. Was there moisturizer built into that tomb thingy?
There was not.
Really? Huh. Well, I guess it's because,
Please, stop talking.
Okay. Yeah, not talking.
I would have just said she...
I cannot sense the shrine.
That she has soft hands.
So
and that's
much
all.
Unrest among your crew. Their emotions are overwhelming me. They look to you for guidance. Help them.
And now this would be a third video for you guys. But I will bring the Walking Dead.
Drax, how are you doing?
I was angry that you did not allow me to guard Nebula.
What that?
But now, I am hopeful. The Forge can bring my family back, if you choose to use it.
Well,
So I must trust you would not take away my chance to reunite with my wife and daughter. Even though you did not behave in a trustworthy manner.
Huh?
You used that antenna woman's powers without permission. It was wrong of you to do that, even if the tree did not mind.
Come on, it wasn't that bad. Was it?
Our feelings are our own. They belong to us alone.
I just wanted to get to know everyone better. We're all so secretive. We should open up more.
Secrets should be shared willingly, not stolen.
Whoa. That was really deep, Drax.
Her ability to see into our emotions, it must be difficult. I would not wish to know the pain of others as well as my own. Thank you for checking in on me, Peter. You may leave now.
So that's good. But I did want
to group.
Know the matter, though.
Oh. Is that a friend of yours?
I am Groot.
I'll tell you this. We're all going to be okay. No matter what happens at the Forge.
I am Groot.
Welcome.
Hey, bud. What's up?
Well, it ain't Captain Indecision.
What are you?
I don't know what's holding you back from doing the right thing here, Quill. I mean, I can count on one paw how many folks ever get a chance to bring back someone they love.
I am Groot.
And what happens if Hala gets a hold of it, huh? This falls into the wrong hands, the whole galaxy is screwed.
The whole galaxy is already screwed. It's always screwed. You think if we destroy this thing, that'll make a difference? Nah. The only ones you're screwing are your so-called friends.
Rocket,
not true.
You know what, Pete? I wish the Forge had never brought you back. Yeah.
I am Groot.
This should have brought someone else. Anyone else back instead.
You don't mean that, Rocket.
Now you're telling me what I don't mean. Man, the ego on you. I meant every day at work.
He's drunk, so that's why.
Have a nice night.
He doesn't mean that right now because he's drunk.
One way to clear his emotional unrest.
I am Groot.
I tried to say everything I could think of. I thought maybe if I asked her to stick around for a while. Ugh, she won't hear it. Not from me. She'll barely even look at me.
So don't give up on her. Family is always worth it.
I know, I'm really trying. But I just can't find the right words with her. Maybe if we had more time, I could try talking to her again when she's calmed down. Give her some space without losing her altogether.
Well, they say time heals all wounds.
Who's they?
I have no idea.
Maybe I can get her to hang around. Just
Maybe not right now. I think she needs some alone time.
Hello.
How about now?
Not that I can tell. There's still something blocking me.
Hey, Nebula. Yeah, hey, it's me, Peter Quill.
Peter Quill, yeah.
But, yeah, but you know that. Mind if I sit? Cool, yeah, this is really, how's the arm?
It's not bad. Would have come in handy to have both arms while fighting off the Kree. I suppose I'm lucky you let me at it all.
Did you get your pills?
So,
yeah.
Thanks, I guess.
Best leader ever, am I right?
Yeah, not really.
Good.
But I can't blame you. Hard to be a decent leader when Gamora's on your team. Speaking of my dear sister... Bet you got an earful. What'd she say about me? That I'm a waste of space. That I deserve everything I've been through.
She says that you won't talk to her. She's really broken up about how you two fell apart.
Well, that's pretty much all thanks to her. Gamora doesn't even realize that she's the reason our family ended.
So, yeah, but that's not how it looked to me.
What do you mean?
When we were in the temple, I saw Gamora's memory of your last mission.
Oh, yeah? What did you see?
She saved your life from that Kree general dude. I mean, he would have killed you if Gamora hadn't stepped in.
No, he wouldn't have. You have no idea what really happened that day. And neither does Gamora. Not all of it, at least.
Then show me.
Now, please take my hand.
If this kills me, I'm going to kick your ass.
At least you guys will have 3 videos at least to watch. I am gonna bring some Walking Dead to you guys right after this video.